Hello, welcome to Sedes with Katie. Today we're going to be working with hand weights. So you're going to need a yoga mat and you're going to need your hand weights and a chair. So we're going to start in cat and cow. So come to a neutral tabletop. Spread all your fingers, wrists underneath the shoulder, knees underneath the hip, top of the feet on the mat. Neutral spine. When you're ready, we're going to go into cat and cow. Inhale, drop your belly, chin on the left, into a cow. Exhale, round your belly as much as you can. Pull your belly tight, lengthen down into a cow. So we're going to do it a few times. And your breath, and your face. Inhale one way. Exhale the other. Connecting your breath with you. Creating spaces between vertebrates. Cat cows are helping with eliminating back pain. Two more times. Inhale. And exhale. One last one. Inhale to cow. Exhale to cat. Slowly, slowly come back to neutral spine. Swing side to side. Release tension in your wrist. Come to arm balance. Or if you like, you grab your hand weights. Set yourself up first. Opposite arm, opposite leg. And we will bring the elbows to meet. So we can do this with our hand weights. You want to grab the hand weights? Go ahead. Gonna do five. Engage your core, abdominal muscles. Crunch it in. Once you're done, slowly, slowly release. Swing side to side. Release tension in your wrist. And we're reaching on the other side. Left arm and right leg. Left thumb to the sky, back to the side. So you're doing it with our hand weight. Elbows do this. Grab the hand weight. Go ahead. Five times. Once you're done, slowly, slowly release. Swing side to side. Extension in your wrist. Coming into a forearm plank. Arms will be shoulders ring, interlacing in front of you, coming up on your tippy toes. We're going to slide forward backwards. Not sticking the butt up, not sagging. Let's do another three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Then come on our knees. Come into a side plank. Bending the left arm parallel to the top of the mat. Make a twist. Palm leg straight. Palm leg bend. You're going to bend the front leg. Bring it close to your body. And you're going to lift your hip up. So if you want to add the hand weight, hold on tight. Bring the arms up. Slowly loose. Inhale and lift the hip up. Exhale down. Control your movement always. Don't swing your arm. Two more. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. Switch inside. Set yourself up. Bending the right arm, parallel to the top of the mat, make a fist, bottom leg straight, top leg bend. Bring the front foot close to your body, stay grounded, and we lift the hip up. So when you're ready, grab the weight, hop up, up. Now slowly release, lower everything down. Feel free to do this with our hand weight. Two more. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. We're gonna push ourselves back up. Come to kneeling. One weight on each side. Shoulders on top of hips. And when you're ready, we're gonna lift the hip up. So we're gonna get this motion going so you can grab your hand weight one at a time. So single first. Sometimes I feel like looking up, but I just can't see my flow and move back and forth. Oh, I want it to go and get something more. I take these on my own. Let's try some doubles. I'm just going to drink and you feel better. Just take a home and you feel better. Telling me that it gets better. Does it ever curl me? If I'm the one who's keeping it, sometimes I feel like giving up. No, another three. Two. And one. Slowly, release. We're gonna get ready to come up. So take your time to rise up, to stand. Once you come all the way up, walk. Alternate bend your knees. Mountain climbing. Nice. Doing some more stretches. Ear to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Stretching out the neck first. Relieve any tension that you may have. And we're going to stay here for three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly come back to center. The other side, you to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Using the same hand, guide, support, head stretch. If there's any stiffness in your neck, any clicking sound, just stay here for a little bit longer. No need to rush. One more breath, slowly, slowly come back to center. Hands on weights for support. Take an inhale to center, exhale, turn up the right shoulder. Only go to where you're comfortable. Inhale, center, exhale, to the side. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Turn up that back. And then change the chest. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Shoulder stretch, right arm up, and across, pull back. Creating resistance, chin is away from the bottom. Eyes are pulled forward. Slowly release, same arm up, place the arm behind the back. Use the other hand to guide out. Bicep stretch, chin up, looking forward. Those who can run hands behind your back, go ahead, find your hands behind your back. Slowly, slowly, we can shift it out to the other side, and across, and across, pull back, creating resistance. Slowly release, same arm up, we lengthen first, place the palm behind the back, use the other hand to guide out, tricep stretch. Try to bring the elbows to the back of your head. Find hands behind you, go ahead. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. Hands on the shoulders, like ab lat. Elbows in, elbows up. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Feel the pinch of your shoulder blades. Opening up long, heart, chest. Improving your posture. When you're in the center position, go into a full circle. Try to draw the elbows close together, pointing the shoulder joints. Change direction, go the other way. Street. slowly, slowly pat back the second. We're going to inhale the arms up to lengthen the spine. Exhale, we're going to bend to the right side. Shoulders and hips are level, chin is away from the body, eyes looking up. Inhale, center, tongue long, exhale to the other side. Shoulders and hips are level, chin is away from the body, eyes looking up. Slowly, slowly come back to center. One more set, exhale to the right. Release the bottom arm, top arm is pressing in. Shoulders and hips are level, chin is away from the body, eyes looking up. Slowly come back up to lengthen the spine. Exhale, we go to the other side. Release the bottom arm, top arm is pressing in. Not pushing the hip forward or back, shoulders and top of hips. Stimulating meridian point, acupuncture point. Stretching internal organs. Slowly come back up. And then we start, check it out. Come into a forward bend. Hands on waist for support. You can inhale first, exhale with a hinge. Leading with a chest. When your back is parallel to the floor, release the hands down. If you can touch the mat, touch the mat. Then go here for a release. If you cannot touch the mat, hold on to opposite elbows up behind the legs. Hip bones above ankle bones. Lengthening the spine. Stretching on the back. Let the blood go the other way for a moment. Just be mindful that head is below heart, so if you don't feel good about this, you need to slowly come out of it. One more breath. We'll get ready to come up. Hands on waist for support. Inhale, halfway up to the flat mat. Exhale to slowly, slowly rise up to standing. Let the breath crush again, adjust it. Once you come all the way up, we're going to go back bend the capital. So move the legs from the behind. Now we stand the roof. Shoulders on top of hips. We're not pushing the stomach forward. Chin is away from the body. Eyes looking up. Good to paint your shoulder blades. Expanding lung, heart, chest capacity. Stimulating thyroid gland. Benefiting chin on now. One more breath here. We're going to slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. We're going to get ready for hand weight. All 10 toes facing in front, legs at your width. Shoulders on top of hips, soft knees, don't lock your knees. Tuck down, close your body, palm facing up. We go single, single first. So we're gonna get this motion going. So if you like, you can have opposite hand, opposite legs, we're just gonna tap. Find your balance, stay grounded. Control your movement always. Don't swing the arm. Engage your core, abdominal muscles always. Chin is away from the body. Eyes and ears. Opposite and opposite legs. Try some doubles. Release nice and slow. Don't swing your arms. For those who have shoulder issues or any issues at all, when you're ready, opposite arm, opposite leg, I'm just tapping.
do some doubles. So it doesn't matter which leg you start first. Let's do another three. Two. And one last one. Slowly release, shake it out. Legs are hip width apart, soft knees. You're gonna bring it up to the chest level. Single, single first. So we're gonna get this motion going. When you're ready, opposite arm, opposite leg. Don't forget to breathe in and out through your nose. Just breathe normally. Heart rate should be going up, but not to the point of hyperventilating. If you find that you can't breathe, heart rate is going up too high and too fast. Slow down. Try some doubles. Let's do another three. Two. I miss the fire, I miss the fire. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Bring the weight above your head. You're gonna drop it. One at a time. Be mindful for shoulder issues. So we'll keep this going. And we're gonna add the opposite arm, opposite leg. A little bit of coordination here. Take your time. Stay grounded. Let's try some doubles.
I wish I never heard your thought. I wish it didn't end like that. I wish it took a gift for some. Give me some of that heartbreak back. And nothing like that is forever. There's nothing like what we have.
Number three.
I wish it took a gift for some. Give me some of that heartbreak back.
And one last one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Come into that drop. So we're going to bring it all the way down to the floor. So we're going to take an inhale first, exhale, hinging from the hips, leading with the chest. We're going to go all the way down. And then we're going to take our time to come up, hinging from the hips again. Neck is long, spine is straight. If you can only do halfway, that's fine. Come halfway and then slowly come up, roll the shoulder back. Continue. Slowly, slowly come down and take your time to rise up. Roll the shoulder back.
And it's better than it ever was without you in the I wish I never heard your thought. I wish it didn't end like that. I wish it took a gift for some. Give me some of that heartbreak back. And nothing ever lasts forever. There's nothing like what we had. I wish it took a gift for some. Give me some of that heartbreak back. Oh, 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 heartbreak back.
Another three. Two. And one last
one.
Slowly, slowly rise up to release. We're going to come to chair. Oh, so let's say it was a mat. I'm going to bring the arm one at a time up. So get this motion going. And we're going to add the knee drop. Single, single first. Slide your tender tables in to protect it up. Don't push the knee beyond the toes. One at a time. Don't go very far down, last two heights. Strong arms, strong core. Continue to work the legs. Let's try some doubles. Let's do another three, two, and one. There we go. Slowly, slowly release. Stepping your legs a little bit wide, your toes are pulling it out. Arms out in T. Shoulder height, palms facing down. Bouncing it side to side. One leg straight, the other leg bent. Once again, slightly tuck the tailbone in to protect your back. Don't push the knee beyond the toes. Strong arms, strong core. Okay, some ways. Dropping the shoulder in. And one last one.
come back and center your breath here, bring the weight to the chest level, rocking side to side. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. Just going to grab one weight, one hand on the weight for support. You're going to touch it down. You're going to go all the way down to the floor. Go ahead. Raise the arm up above your head. And modification, halfway up. Practice arm. Be mindful. Don't pull up the back muscle. Watch your knees. Some shoulder roll, release any tension that you may have. Have that to the body and even spirit. So if you like, you can do single first. Get this motion going.
One arm is clockwise, the other arm is counterclockwise. So if you like, you can do the legs as well. Same leg, same arm, opposite leg, your choice. We're just gonna incorporate the arms and leg movement together. Coming back to center, pause it here. I'm gonna do both arms. So we're gonna get this motion going again. Once again, if you wanna add the legs, go ahead. Get the brain busy to coordinate the movement. Two more. And one last one. Pause it here for a moment, and we're gonna change direction. Get this motion going. And when you're ready, you can add the legs. Let's do another three. Two. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. So we're just gonna have a water break. Have a sip of water if needed. Ready? Grab your weight. Legs are your width apart and give you a side view. Have you ever closed your body? We're gonna do it. Extend. Don't swing. Control your movement always. Ready? Opposite arm, opposite leg. So I'm gonna tap back this time. One at a time. Get the motion going. No need to hurry. Try both arms. Drop. I'm just doing one at a time first. Let's do another three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. You're gonna need one weight only, one in the stand, toes are pulling out. You're gonna pass the weight from one behind one leg to the other leg. So I'm gonna hold on to the end of the weight, so we're gonna come down. So we're passing the weight from one hand to the other hand. Stretch out the hamstrings. Shift the weight to one leg, doesn't matter which one, bring up the other leg. Point the toes up to the ceiling, square the hips to the front. If this is too hard for you, leave the leg on the ground. Inhale, arms up above the head. Lengthen, exhale, bring it forward, pull longer. Holding on to any on the foot, the legs of the chair. Chin is away from the one. Eyes looking forward. Neck is long, spine straight. And we're gonna stay here for three, two. Feel the stretch in the hamstrings, like you bend the knee and feel it. One more breath, and we'll slowly, slowly release. alternating belly moves, mantra plank, bicycle, any base pressure that you may have. So we're with it on the outside, hamstring stretch. Point the toes up to the ceiling, square it to your front. When you're ready, inhale your arms up to your leg for the spine, exhale. Over the arm to the chair, front of the legs. Chin is away from the heart, eyes on the front. Next arm, spine straight. And when you stay, kiss. Four, three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly rise up. Alternating, bend the knees. Mountain climbing bicycle. Quadriceps stretch. So you shift the weight to the inside. Holding on to the chair to set up. Grab the hold the other foot or ankles. So open up the knees, knees together. Take the foot into your head. Chest away from the body. Eyes looking forward. Legs long, spine straight. You want to join the balance. Go into the dancer. That's a burn. Looking at a focal point on the floor or at the horizon. When you have enough of it, slowly, slowly release. Alternating bend the knees, mountain climb, bicycle. Release any tension that you may have. Now we will repeat on the outside. So you shift the weight to center, grab a hold of the other foot on the foot, knees together, take the foot into your hand. Abs are firm, eyes looking at a focal point on the floor or at the horizon. Feel free to turn into balancing. Working the standing leg and ankle, strengthening the quadriceps, the leg muscle to support the function. No muscle in the knees. We're going to slowly, slowly release. Alternating bending the knees. Mountain climbing, bicycle. We're going to curl up the knees next. Shift the weight to one leg, doesn't matter which one. And the other leg. Small little kick. Firming up your glutes, firming up your butts. For those who wish to chant themselves, feel free to cross at the apple. Let's do another three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. Alternating bend your knees, mountain climbing, bicycle. Leave any tension that you may have. And then repeat on the outside. Shift the weight to your standing leg. Smaller, okay. Abs are firm. Chin is away from the body. Eyes looking at your focal point. Feel free to cross your elbow. Your choice. Let's do another three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. Alternating bending, mountain climbing, bicycle. Leave any tension that you may have. Go back to weight. Do elbows to move. Inside leg is the same leg. Holding on to your chair first to set up. When you're ready, elbows to move. Flexing the outside foot. Raise your arms up above your head, if it is accessible. Always remember, halfway are fine, so practice arms are fine. Let's do another three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. Switching side. Shift the weight to the standing leg. Outside hand can be on your waist for support. You can go to the other side of the chair if you want to hold on to the chair. So when you're ready, elbows to knee, flexing the outside foot. You got that taste, Let's do another three. Two. One. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it up. And with that one, the chair. So we're going to put the chair away. Coming back to combination. Obvious thing. Front is 90-degree on top ankle, which it doesn't let the knee out. Back foot is at 45. Square the hip. And when you're ready, you're going to move the weight underneath your knee. Open shut in the middle. Up and down at the top. Extend at the bottom. Four different parts. So one, move it underneath the knee. Two, open shut. Make sure you can see the weight in front of you. Three, up and down at the top. Four, extend at the back. So go at your own breath and your own pace. Next, I hope we're apart. We're going to come forward. So we're going to push it forward. We're not leaning forward. We're going to stay grounded. So if you like, you can tap out Tuck the elbow close to your body. Open, shut in the middle. Extend at the back. Knee up at the top. Forward. Tap. Side. Tap. Back. Tap. Push it up. Knee up. For your breath and your pace. She's so beautiful. Some water first before you lie down. Bend your knees, your spine will automatically release, keeping the neck to curve in your lower back. And then when you slide, palm facing down, slightly tuck the chin in to protect your neck. Taking a few common breath here, let your body get used to lying on its back. Coming into wind, releasing on the right side, wrap your hands around the right knee, draw it close to the chest or armpit. Give it a good squeeze, point the left toes up to the ceiling. Massaging all this on the right side as well as ascending colon. From here, we're gonna go to a spinal twist, right foot on left thigh, opposite arm, opposite foot. Right arm up to the right, palm facing down. Your neck is good, turn a little bit to the right side. Hips automatically comes off. Stretch, strengthen, and tone the lower back muscles. Keeping your spine healthy and strong. One more breath here. We're going to slowly, slowly release. Bring everything back to center. Straighten out the legs. Back to three times. Wind releasing on the left side. Wrap your hands around the left knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpit. Give it a good squeeze. Massage your legs on the left side as well as descending forward. So anytime you feel bloated or constipated, wind releasing. And see if it's going to bring you any relief. Session is fine with this. Left foot on right thigh, opposite hand, opposite thigh. Slowly guiding completely as close to the floor as possible. Left arm out to the right, arms facing down. Turn over to the left side, relax.
creating spaces between alpha and alpha, helping you to reduce back pains. Couple more breaths here. And we'll slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs. Balance everything times. Bend both knees. Wrap your arms around your knees. We'll rock side to side. Knee to chest. Come into big circle of motion if you like. Cover your big area. Massaging lower back and sacrum. Also helping you to relieve back pain. Change direction. Go the other way. Slowly come back to center. Feet up to the sky, create a happy baby. Bend both knees, hands on the bottom of the feet. Press down so that the knees are close to the armpits. And you can also walk side to side, massaging the entire spine and entire back. Opening up the hip Slowly come back to center, straighten out the legs, flex the feet, palm down by your side, palm facing down. Let the blood circulate back to your heart, stretching our hamstrings, energize the body. Once you have good blood circulation, it may improve your overall wellness, increase your immunity level, improve your digestion and sleep quality. Couple more breaths here. And we are slowly with control, release the legs back down on the mat. Once you come all the way down, balance it a few times. Bend both knees, raise your right arm, roll over to the right side of the body. Coming into a fetus position. And when you're ready, use your top to push yourself up. Coming into a comfortable seated position, sitting up nice and tall. So we've come to the end of the session, so thank you very much for joining me, sharing your energy with all of us, and letting me find a few more out. Always my pleasure.